three basic thoughts of Old Testament. God's promise to Abraham that in his seed all nations should be blessed. God founded the Hebrew nation for the specific purpose of making it a messianic nation to the world. That is, a nation through which great blessing would come to all nations. Secondly, God's covenant with the Hebrew nation, that if they would faithfully serve Him, they would prosper as a nation. That if they forsook Him and serve idols, they would be destroyed as a nation. All nations worship idols that were gods everywhere, gods of the sky, gods of the earth, gods of the sea, gods of the land, gods of the cities, gods of the country, gods of the mountain, gods of the valleys, male gods, female gods, families of God. The Old Testament is the account of God's age-long effort to establish in a world of idol-worshipping nation the idea that there is one God by building a nation around the idea. Thirdly, God promised to David that his family should reign over God's people forever. When God's nation become a great nation, God choose one family in the nation, the family of David, and began to build around that family's promises. That out of the family there would come one great king who would himself personally live forever and establish a universal kingdom of endless duration. Three step in progress of Old Testament thought. The Hebrew nation was founded that through them the whole world should be blessed, the messianic nation. The way that Hebrew nation would bless the world would be through the family of David, the messianic family. The way the family would bless the world would be through one great king to be born in the family, the Messiah. This In founding the Hebrew nation, God's ultimate object was to bring Christ into the world. God's immediate object was to establish in a world of idolatry. As a background to the coming of Christ, the idea that there is one true living God.